Spiel is made for the kids of Wisconsin by the people at Wisconsin Public Television and the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association. 3, 2, 1. Get real.
Get real.
Real cool.
Yeah! Hey, this is Get Real.
And this is your show.
Hi, I'm Asa Derks, and I'm from Ridgeway.
I'm Shannon Lowe, and I'm from Madison. Get Real is going to take us and you all over Wisconsin to a ton of cool places.
Some will be places kids don't usually get to go.
Others will be great places to visit.
Like the Madison Children's Museum, where we are today.
And all along the way, we're going to meet a great bunch of kids.
So while you're watching, listen up for how you can write in, and maybe we'll show up in your town.
Today, we're going to meet an 11-year-old national karate champion.
We'll also visit a Wisconsin clinic that treats injured wild animals, including a cougar. But first, we'll be going to the theater.
Melody Kay starred in the Broadway musical, The Secret Garden.
When the play came to our area, Melody invited Get Real backstage.
Hi, I'm Melody Kay, and I'm an actress in the Broadway musical, The Secret Garden, now touring America. When I was six, I saw my cousin in a play, and I was like, oh, I want to do this, you know. Well, I went backstage and I saw the dressing rooms and I saw the girls putting on makeup. I saw the costumes and it all excited me so much.
A place where I can read my heart be still, indeed will mind. A place where I can go when I am lost, and there I'll find me.
First night I went on Broadway, I was a nervous wreck until I got on stage.
It's your pretty mother, is it?
No, it isn't.
I like when I go on stage and I can express my feelings through acting.
The rest to come, for in all of us to come, for in all the world to come.
This is what I do before the show. I wear the underwear, and then I put this dress on. And then, since I have a really quick change, this is extremely hot, I have to put this nightgown on over it. These are my cough drops for the show. They keep my breath smelling well, and they help me sing. I have this beautiful hat. This is my favorite costume in the whole show. These are some cleanserizers I wear in the show. I change into this hat to be a little bit nicer. There's some lipsticks I wear that I love. It's like long and frilly and it's really pretty. Flower I wore on opening night in Cleveland in the show. I wore it in my hair. And it's a happy dress. I like it.
It looked like there was purpose. What is this language you speak?
I love being on tour. I love it. It's lots of fun. It's seeing all these new places I've never been to before. Some places we've been to, Cleveland, St. Louis, Miami, and St. Paul, Dallas. We're going to places like LA and Toronto, and it's gonna be really exciting. That's where I would want to sit. Those are the best seats in the house. And you know what I like about this theater is I like the closeness of the people. Everybody's close, and I can see them as I do my work on stage. My family's helped me a lot. My whole family is just helps by telling me supportive words. That's what you really need to do, is to tell your kids, you're doing wonderful and I'm very proud of you. It's a dream come true to me.
Welcome to the Wisconsin State Capitol. This is where the governor, Tommy Thompson, has his office. It's also where our state representatives and senators meet. And it's where the Wisconsin Supreme Court is. It took 10 years to build a Capitol. One reason it took so long is the dome. It's more than 200 feet around. Do you know where in Wisconsin the state capitol is?
Hold it. That's way too easy. Everybody knows that the capital of Wisconsin is in Madison.
Okay, you're right. The current state capital is Madison, but it wasn't always there. This town was the first state capital. And this building is where Wisconsin's first governor met with the first legislature. Do you know where in Wisconsin the first state capital was? See if you can figure it out, and we'll let you in on the answer later in the show.
Our next story is about a world-famous tumbling team.
The Jesse White Tumblers from Chicago thrill audiences with their amazing stunts, but they also have a serious message for kids.
Recently, the team visited Columbus.
We're the Jesse White Tumbling Team, and we tumble around the world for different companies and performances and stuff like that.
We performed with the Chicago Bears, Chicago Bulls, Chicago White Sox, Marquette Warriors, Milwaukee Bucks, Green Bay Packers. Jump. Yo, it's fun, you know, seeing your body just go real fast.
It's like you're flying in an airplane, but you don't have any engines, but you're the pilot and the co-pilot.
Team practices two afternoons a week and on weekends. And to be on this world-famous team, you have to follow the rules.
You can't use profanity. You can't drink, smoke. You know, that's mainly it. You know, you can't fight with each other.
The tumbling team comes from a pretty bad neighborhood where people have gotten beat up by gangs or shot.
Just, bad over. Lots of gang violence, shooting, and people just being bad.
Team members can't join gangs, and they have to stay in school.
If you don't go to school, don't have a good education, you can't be a part of this team.
Bobby Poindexter is an assistant coach for the team. He says all the time spent practicing and the rules help the kids deal with living in a rough neighborhood.
Well, it keeps them off the street, keep them from being into a gangbanger, keep them from doing drugs, doing alcohol and smoking, and giving them something positive to do instead of something negative to do.
Tumblers say the rules are what help make the team so good, and they've turned their rules into messages for the kids who watch them perform.
Don't do drugs, and please don't get in a gang. Because if you do drugs, you'll get hurt and might die, and if you're in a gang, you'll get probably shot, or you'll get hurt really bad and have to be in the hospital.
When the team gives a performance, there's still one more very important message.
Don't try this at home.
Looking for a good movie? Well, I'm Dominic, and I'll be telling you what to pick and what to pass next time you're scouting the shelves for a video to rent. Today we're checking out the movie, Honey, I Blew Up the Kid.
Peek-a-boo! I blew up the baby!
It's the sequel to Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, and Robert Oliveira is back as Nick.
My little brother, we have a little brother now, gets enlarged or blown up. And actually kidnaps me, literally, and the girl that comes to babysit him. Picks us both up, puts him in his pocket, and kind of carts us around Las Vegas while he's demolishing the town.
The special effects are really cool. The baby towers over his family and eventually the city of Las Vegas. They actually had to shut down the Las Vegas lights in order to shoot this scene. As the baby grows, so do his clothes and even his toy bunny.
Can anyone tell me where the bunny is?
There!
You think it's still on my head?
One of the best effects was out of the kid's pocket.
It's 28 feet wide and 22 feet deep is his pocket. Anything you could possibly imagine that could be in a little kid's pocket is in there.
Is he growing or are we shrinking?
It's amazing. He's doubled in size in just a few minutes.
It's so amazing. It looks so real. It's just this huge 2.5-year-old. All the people are running around going, ah!
Honey, I Blew Up the Kid is a pretty good movie. But I do think it could have been better. In my opinion, Honey, I Shrunk the Kids was a better movie. In that movie, the kids are small and the whole world is the special effect. But in Honey, I Blew Up the kid is the special effect. Not as much danger, not as much excitement, just one big baby. It's a fun movie with some neat moments. But when you have to choose between the two, pick Honey, I Shrunk the Kids first. And as for Honey, I Blew Up the Kid, it gets a 75% Dominic approved.
Have you figured out where the first state capital was? Here's a hint. It's not Milwaukee, Green Bay, Superior, Eau Claire, La Crosse, or any other big city. In fact, the first state capital has fewer than 1,000 people, and it's right down the road from a state park. Keep trying to figure it out. The answer's coming up in just a few minutes.
One of the things Wisconsin is famous for is dairy products, which of course come from cows.
Besides domestic animals, like cows, there's also a lot of wild animals here, but sometimes those animals get hurt.
Today, we're going to a wildlife sanctuary, where Patrine reports for Get Real.
Every day, wild animals are injured. If they're lucky, they're found and brought to a wildlife sanctuary, like the Bay Beach Wildlife Sanctuary in Green Bay. Would you describe some of the animals that you have here?
Many of the common animals that people find throughout Wisconsin in the woods and fields eventually find their way to the wildlife sanctuary. Every year we receive over 2,500 animals from the public, injured and orphaned animals. And we mainly can do the rehabilitation, strengthening the animal so that it's able to be released back into the wild, because that's our real goal, to see the animals released back into the wild.
The animal hospital at the wildlife sanctuary gives most of these animals a second chance. This owl has a foot injury and can't hunt.
The first problem we have to address with this bird is its weakness and the starvation. And basically it's on a very liquid, easy to digest diet.
Once it's healthy, this owl will be released. But some animals can never be returned to the wild because their injuries are too bad. This cougar has a hip injury, so he can't run very well.
But that's one of the ways we can give him exercise and exercise that hip so that the muscles become strong enough to hold the bones in place.
If he were released, he couldn't hunt and might starve. So, he'll always live here. But this owl is healthy and ready to fly away today.
Yeah, he'll smell. An animal in the wild is like a highly trained athlete. They have to be in really good condition in order to survive. They're creatures that share the earth with us, and they have a place here too.
Okay, you have them?
Yeah.
Okay, you know what we're going to do now?
What?
We're going to bend down like this and throw him up into the air.
Okay.
See how he does. Okay, ready? On the count of three.
One,
two, three.
Get real.
Now listen up and hear me out. Just let me tell you what this book's about. How to eat fried worms is a scheme of the jam. They cook them, boil them, and eat them with ham. There's Joe and Billy and all the guys. There's a bet going on with Billy and Joe to eat 15 worms, does he? Well, I don't know. But if you want to find out, there is no doubt that your local library will help you check it out. So if you like to laugh and you like to read, How to Eat Fried Worms is the book that you need.
We get a letter from Jason Klaus of Green Bay. Jason's 9 and he wrote, Dear Get Real, I'd like to ask Wisconsin kids, what's the first thing you would do if you were president of the United States? That's a good question. So we went to Putnam Heights Elementary School in Eau Claire to get some opinions.
If I were president, I would reserve land for animals so, like, they couldn't get killed or anything.
I'd make a new job to help the environment.
I would lower taxes.
The first thing I would do if I was president is get a lot of money and build homes for the homeless people.
I would give money to the poor because they wouldn't maybe have enough to eat or something.
First thing I'd do if I were president, I would help not just our country with homeless, but other countries by sending people over there and giving them food.
I would lower helping other countries because we still have hungry and poor people in ours and homeless, and they need help.
The first thing I would do is to build more affordable houses because people who work hard and have two incomes still can't afford houses.
Pay off all the debt that America's in.
I would go across the United States trying to get people to help clean up our environment.
That's what we think!
If you have a question you want Get Real to ask other kids about, write us a letter. Grab a pencil and a piece of paper so you'll be ready when we give you our address later on in the show.
The next kid we're lucky enough to meet is a national karate champion.
Justin Margado is from Green Bay.
Kick it.
I began studying karate when I was about 5.5 years old. My parents really started me up, and I really didn't want to go. But after I got my uniform on, I just wanted to keep on going.
Karate teaches you self-discipline, to pay attention in school. It helps you with good control, and it's good self-defense.
Kids like to tease me about it because I'm a black belt. And from karate, I learned just to ignore them. I like competing in tournaments and winning trophies and learning stuff and teaching other students. Just like they taught me, and now I get to teach the new kids.
Come on, swing.
126 trophies all total. This is one of my favorite uniforms. It has my name on the back. This one is my first place at a national tournament. And this is where I won grand champion, where I won $50, where I beat my instructor. And this is my first trophy. I was 5 at the time. And this one is a first place at the Diamond Nationals. That's where I've always wanted to get a first place at, because it's the biggest tournament all around. Karate gives you a lot of confidence, you know, to believe in yourself. I practice about 5 to 6 hours a week, and I have 4 classes. I think it's really worth it. My first goal was to get my black belt, and I got that. Then my second goal was to be #1 in the nation and to get a national first place. I've got that. Then my goal right now is to be on a national karate team called the Metro All-Stars. That's a team where you get to go all over the world. I'm hoping to be on that team. So I'm always just gonna try to do my best and win. Nothing good about losing, but. Well, there is one thing, trying your best. If you think you tried your best, then you succeed. You did not lose, you won. I've got the power!
Wow, Justin's ways of setting goals for himself is really good. One of the goals here at the Children's Museum is to get people to recycle, and there's a whole room set aside for recycle art.
Companies donate things that would normally be thrown away, but we can use them to make real cool stuff.
Come on. Well, it's fun to make stuff. Most of us like to buy toys when we can save up enough money.
Yeah, a lot of you have told us at Get Real that you hate it when you buy something and it turns out not to be as good as you thought. So our toy reviewers are out in search of real cool stuff.
Hi, I'm Emily Reese.
Hi, I'm Ted Reese.
And today we're at the sledding hill to try out all the new kinds of sleds.
First, we're going to try the old traditional kind. First, the flexible flyer, then the soft.
Some sort of wax or something on the bottom, but put wax on the bottom of your runner sled and don't go in deep snow.
I love my melted snow behind me. My, it just
burns. The steering isn't very good, but it's really fun.
These inflatable sleds are really nice because you don't bruise yourself when you go off the jumps or anything.
These are the plastic sleds. They cost about $10.
I'm gonna 1972 Mustang!
This one goes off to the right. They tried to steer it, except it didn't work.
So, if you want to go fast, pick inflatable sleds. But steer clear of sticks, you might poke holes.
Plastic sleds don't wear out as fast, but they're harder to steer.
This is good old-fashioned cardboard. If you want a free sled, you can go and just rip a piece out.
We'll be back next time with more cool stuff!
If you said the first state capital was Belmont, you're right. Belmont is a small town in Lafayette County. In 1836, Wisconsin's first governor, Henry Dodge, addressed the legislature here. The Supreme Court met right next door, but many legislators weren't happy with Belmont as a location, and they voted to name Madison the permanent capital of Wisconsin.
If you want your town to be on our Where in Wisconsin map,
write us a letter and tell us why. Tell us what makes your town cool, and your letter just might be on our next show.
Send your letter to
Get Real, 821 University Avenue, Madison, Wisconsin, 53706. And be sure to include your name, age, and telephone number.
Well, that's all for today's show,
but always remember to
get real!
Get real!
Is made for the kids of Wisconsin by the people at Wisconsin Public Television and the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association.